It always amuses me that for 7 years in a row now, the New York Philharmonic has hired an Englishman to conduct the Independence Day concert, sort of rubbing it in, isn't it, really? But it's always a thrill for me to be able to conduct some of the great American music that there is. And we're playing an arrangement called Memories of America, which is an arrangement of traditional American tunes. We're also joined for this concert by the United States Military Academy Band with Colonel Timothy Holton, commander and conductor. The repertoire, in addition to the Memories of America, includes Gershwin's American in Paris. In a sense, it's a concerto for this great orchestra because there are solos all around the orchestra, violin solos, trumpet solos. Different instruments in the orchestra have moments in the sun. After intermission, the band will play Milton Gould's Symphony No. 4, great American classic, and then, together with the orchestra, we'll play Randall Bass's L'Esprit du Tour, followed by a Sousa march that's not heard so often in the national game, certainly one that we've not done before at the Summertime Classics concerts. And then the wonderful Armed Services medley, which always actually moves me, even as a Brit. So as you get to each individual service that's celebrated in this great and famous medley, the members of that service or former members of that service stand and are acknowledged by the crowd. Finishing, of course, with the great march, the Stars and Stripes Forever. When we play this at Summertime Classics, which we've done, I think, every year in the last 7 years, the brass of the New York Philharmonic rise from their seats. The effect is overwhelming. There'll be something like 250 performers on stage performing this great Sousa march, which really encapsulates everything that's wonderful about July 4th, and we're just thrilled to be able to bring it to our audiences.